A very good morning, dear children. Welcome back to the class. So in our today's class, we are going to learn divide and check. So we are going to do division with remainder and we are going to check as well. Okay, so every one of you take out your notebook, write there today's date, write there division chapter name, and let's start the first question. So children, let's do our first question. Divide 73 divided by 6. The first number is our dividend. 73 is our what? Dividend. Then 6 is what, children? Divisor, the number by which dividend is divided. Okay? Quotient is what, children? Answer, which we are going to find. And let's see whether we get the remainder or not. So let's start. So first, inside we write dividend. Inside we write dividend and outside we write divisor. Okay? Outside we write divisor. Children, this 3 is in 1's place. 7 is in 10's place. When we do division, children, we start from our left side. On our left side, which place is there? 10's place, right? Generally, we start our multiplication, addition, subtraction, everything from the 1's place. But division, children, starts from the left side. That is, whichever place is there, hundreds, tens, whatever place is there. So here you can see on my left side, which place is there? 10's. So first we are going to divide 7. So let's see. In the table of 6, we are going to see the table of 6. In the table of 6, does 7 comes? Let's see. 6 ones are 6. 6 twos are 12. 7 does not come. Right, children? We are taking only one digit here. 7. So 7 does not come, children. So in this case, what we are going to do, we are going to take the number smaller than 7. So smaller than 7 is 6. So we will go with 6 ones are, we'll go with 6 ones are 6. 6, 1 we will write in quotient place and 6 we will write below 7. Now we will subtract this. 7 minus 6 is what, children? 1. Very good. Now we will move to 1's place. So in 1's place, what is the digit here? 3. So we will bring this 3 down. Now it becomes what? 13. Now again we have to see the table of 6. Does 13 comes in the table of 6? See here, 6 ones are 6. 6 twos are 12. Then 6 threes are 18. So children, 18 is more than 13. So it means that 13 does not come. So children, we cannot go more than 13. We can go with the number less than 13. Why? Because we can subtract. Okay, we subtract smaller number from the bigger number. So we can take this number, children. 6 into 2 is 12. That is 6 twos are 2. We will write in 1's place. 6 twos are 12. Now you subtract. 3 minus 2 is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. So children, is there any other number after 1's? No. So we will stop here. And it can't be divided more. So children, this is what? This is our remainder. This is our remainder. 73 is our dividend. 12 is our answer, that is quotient. And 6 is what, children? Divisor. 6 is our divisor. We divide 73 dividend by divisor. So which table we see, children? We see the table of divisor. Okay, it is 6, so we will see the table of divisor. So now we can say that our quotient is 12 and remainder is 1. Now children, let's check the answer, whether our answer is right or not. If we get the dividend, that means our answer is correct. So let's start. You can note down this, children, and I'm going to write. So children, now let's check the answer. What is the formula of checking the answer, children? Quotient multiply by divisor plus remainder is equal to dividend. Okay, so our quotient is what, children? What did we get the quotient? 12. So we'll write 12 below quotient, then we will give this multiply sign. What is our divisor, children? Our divisor is 6. So we'll write 6 below divisor. Plus sign is here after this. Remainder. What is our remainder, children? 1 is equal to dividend. And our dividend is what, children? 73. We will not write the dividend. We will calculate this. If we get 73, dividend is equal to 73. That means our answer is correct. So let's see. 12 sixa is what? 12 sixa 72. Correct. Then plus 1 is equal to dividend. Dividend you can write below it. Then 72 plus 1 is what, children? 73. So is equal to dividend. Dividend will keep writing, children. Now you just see dividend is equal to, we can say that dividend is equal to 73. See dividend, what came? 73. And our dividend is what? 73. That means our answer is correct. So this is how we divide and check the answer. So let's do one word problem. So children, let's see example 9 of your textbook, that is page number 85. Yusuf bought 95 chocolates for the children of an orphanage on Children's Day. So how many chocolates did Yusuf bought? He bought 95 chocolates, right? So what can be the statement? Number of chocolates Yusuf bought. Next line you see. He packed them in packets. Where did he pack? These 95 chocolates, where did he pack? In packets. He packed them in packets of 7 chocolates each. What does it mean, children? 7 chocolates each. That means in one packet, how many chocolates? In one packet, children, 7 chocolates. In one packet, 7 chocolates. How many packets of chocolates did he make? So I told you, children, what is division, right? When we split the total into groups to find the number of groups, we do division. So children, we are going to find how many groups are required, how many packets are required, right? How many packets are required? If in one packet, 7 chocolates, so 95 chocolates will be in how many packets? How can we do, children? We are going to do divide. Because you know that in one packet, 7 chocolates are there. Okay? How many packets of chocolates did he make? He make how many packets? We are going to find that. Were any chocolates left over after putting, children, 7 chocolates in each packet? Is there any chocolates remain? That also we are going to find out. Hope the question is clear to everyone. Now let's solve. You can write down the question. So children, let's solve the example. The first line is, Yusuf bought 95 chocolates for children of an orphanage on Children's Day. So how can we write the statement? Number of chocolates Yusuf bought is equal to 95. Next line is, children, he packed them in packets of 7 chocolates each. He packed in packets of 7 chocolates each. Each means in one packet 7 chocolates. So number of chocolates in each packet is equal to 7. Next line, children, they ask, what is the question here now? How many packets of chocolates did he make? So we are finding here the group of chocolate packets, right? We have to find the number of groups. So children, when we find the number of groups, what we do? Division. What we do? Division. So how can we write? Therefore, number of packets of chocolates he makes is equal to 95 divided by 7. Now let's divide. So we always start from, this is the tens place and ones. We start from left side, children, and our left side is 9. That is tens place. We have to see the table of which number? Divisor, that is 7. Now we have to see that 9, does 9 comes in 7's table or not? 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14. So children, here it comes 14. That means 9 does not come in the table of 7. So in that case, what we will do? We will always go with the number smaller than 9. So 7 is smaller than 9. 7 is smaller than 9. So we'll go with 7. We cannot take 14, children, because 14 is bigger, and moreover we cannot subtract with 14. Okay? So we'll go with smaller number. Smaller than 9 is 7. 7 ones are 7. Write this 7 below 9. Give you a minus sign. Subtract this place. 9 minus 7 is what? 2. Very good. Now you bring this 5 down. Okay. Now what is the number here? 25. Now we have to see that does 25 comes in 7 table? Let's see. 7 2's are 14. 7 3's are 21. 7 4's are 28. So here it is. More than 25 is 28, but 25 does not come. So if 25 does not come, children, what we will do? We'll go with the number smaller than 25, that is 21. So we'll take this. 7 is written here. 7, 3, 3 is the answer. This is the answer. 7, 3's are 21 comes here. Now let's subtract. 5 minus 1 is 4, and 2 minus 2 is 0. So children, we cannot divide after this, so we'll stop here. You know that this is our remainder. This is our remainder, and this is our answer, quotient. Okay? So now let's write the answer, children. What we can write here? How can we write? Number of packets of chocolates he makes. How many packets did he make? 13. So children, our answer is 13 packets and 4 chocolates left over. So this is our word problem. We have solved our word problem. Practice at home. You can note down this in your notebook. So that's all for today. Thank you so much. Have a good day.